the theme. The church is the light that can't be hid. Matthew chapter 5, verses 14 through 16.
He's a buddy of mine. He's a friend of mine. And from the first day I met him and knew that he would pursue the preaching of the gospel, I knew that this was a dedicated guy. He wanted to do it. He wanted to do it more. And I know that he's going to come and bring something tonight. He'd always brought something.
Let us say amen.
Amen.
The God of heaven has been gracious to us, good to us, kind and merciful, and we're thankful to be with the saints of God. I'm home tonight. I'm home back here in Gainesville, Florida. This is my home, and we thank God for this blessed occasion. We thank the Lord for this lectureship, Florida State Lectureship. We are thankful to the Master for his kindness, his grace, and his mercy. We're thankful for the North Central Florida Fellowship of the Church of Christ for allowing me the opportunity to say something on behalf of King Jesus. These men, many of them are my mentors. I thank God for Brother Dickerson, Brother Davis, Brother C.L. White, and thank God for Brother Larry and for Brother Harper Jr., this great preacher here at 10th Avenue Church of Christ as well. And we thank God for the 10th Ave family. That's my family. And we give God all the praise, the glory, the honor, and the thanks. And I need to move forward. I know what it's like preaching on these events. Your time leaves quite fast. I paid off the timekeeper, but I don't know if that's going to work. So we better get right into the word and move out of the way for these for the real preachers to come, Brother Snell and Brother Wesley T. Leonard. Brother Leonard took me on his wing many years ago. Many years ago, I can't thank him enough for that. I can't thank him enough. When I was just starting out in the ministry, my wife and I would go down there, and I thank God for Brianna, and I thank God for Jonathan. They let us eat hot dogs with them, I'm telling you, the French fries and all that, and the greens and the beans and weenies, they let us just come on in the house. And they took care of us. We thank God for them. All the so many of my sisters and brothers, mentors, moms and dads here in Gainesville and North Central Florida area. I could go on and on about you, what you mean to us. We're just sorry we haven't been able to come back home that much, but we're there in Jacksonville at the Northside Church of Christ. They're taking good care of us. Taking good care of us, and we're busy for the Lord. God is blessing us, and we thank God for that church there. And we have over 1,600 members, so we stay busy. We stay busy. But the Lord is good. We thank God for Brother Charlie McClendon. We're working very well together. I'm sure, I believe, some told him, don't let that young man come up there. And some certainly told me, don't go up there. Preachers can't work together like that. But God put us together. God put us together. And we're working together like Moses and Joshua worked together. Elijah and Elisha worked together. Paul and Timothy worked together. And that's how we're working together. Okay, if you don't get those references, Batman and Robin worked together. Okay, Batman and Robin worked together. Yes, we're up there dealing with some jokers. We've got some jokers in Jacksonville. And we got a whole lot of Riddlers up there, I'm telling you. A whole lot of Two-Face, too. You know? We try to help them put down one of their faces, you know. As Winston T. Leonard would say, we pray for us with the cat women, too. Pray for us with the cat women. We're trying to help them. I thank God that my wife is here, Nisha Jackson. She's here. Wave your hand. I want them to see you so they know you're mine and nobody start nothing. Praise God. Nobody start nothing. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My mom is here, Sister Rita Jackson. Wave your hand, Mom. She dynamite single mother, raised me and my sister by herself, and we thank God for her. And my in-laws, technically in-laws, are here, Brother and Sister Holden, and we thank God for them, and Aunt Sheila as well, and all of our family. Matthew chapter 5, the Word of God is able to save our souls. We give God all the praise for all these dynamic speakers, preachers, teachers that have come before, and those who will come after us. Matthew 5, verse 13, the Bible says, "You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt has lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing. It is good only to be cast out and trodden under the foot of men." Our subject that I've been given, have we lost our savor? Have we lost our savor? That is the question tonight. Have we lost our savor? We need to examine ourselves and make sure we have not lost our savor. Well, before we deal with the savor, we need to talk about the salt. What is salt? And many of us know what salt is. Sodium chloride. It has over 14,000 uses. Salt is called the most important ingredient in food. It is the foundation, one professional chef said, of all good cooking. Sodium chloride is the smallest ingredient in your meal, but it makes the greatest impact upon your meal. Salt experts say it comes from water, fire, and time. Water, fire, and time. Salt is not influenced by its environment, but it influences its environment. It has so much in, so much power and potency inside of it. No matter what you put it on, salt will have more power over the environment than the environment has on the salt. Salt is, it destroys ice on winter roads. Salt is naturally recyclable. It's a flavor enhancer. Jesus said, "You are the flavor enhancer of the world. You are the preservative of the world. You are the influencer of the world. You are the one that provides flavor on the job, flavor in the home, flavor in the congregation." And we need to be the salt that Jesus designed for us to be. What is salt? The Savior calls us the salt of the earth. The Savior talked to an audience that understood what he was saying. They could relate to this firsthand, because dead sea salt could leave a bad taste in your mouth under wrong conditions because of impurities. If the salt is combined with something else, it could lose its saltiness, lose its savor. So the Master is telling us not to be influenced by the world. If we're going to let the light shine, we need to be influencers of the world. I tell the young people that when I come into an environment, the environment doesn't happen to me. I happen to the environment. I told the folks in Jacksonville, "You all aren't going to happen to me. I happen to Northside." I played on the team for the Florida Gators many, many years ago, brother. Now it's many years ago. I'm glad for that. I'm a Gator. I'm glad to be a Gator. Some of the folks in Jacksonville, Brother Kenny G, they tell me I need to try out again. And then I tell them, when I was there, we won rings. We won championships. Yeah, we beat Seminoles too. But anyway, we beat them then. But you need to happen to your environment. What is the characteristics of salt? Jesus, our Savior, in this Sermon on the Mount, which is a masterful exposition of the law and a potent assault on the Pharisee legalism. Don't have time. We should have time to deal with all that. But the Savior fully examines and explains the meaning of the law and the superiority of the new covenant. Matthew 5 and 3. Blessed Blessed are the poor in spirit. The Savior is emphasizing the fact that this is the opposite of self-sufficiency. When you know that you know that you know that you couldn't make it without the Lord, you couldn't do it without the Master, you wouldn't be where you are without Jesus Christ. It's those of us that think we got it going on, we know everything, nobody can tell us anything, God can't do anything with you. But when you're poor in spirit, when you don't have a self-exalting attitude, now the Savior can do something with it.